Jacob lived in the land of his father's sojournings, in the land of Canaan. These are the generations of Jacob. Joseph, being 17 years old, was pasturing the flocks with his brothers. He was a boy with the sons of Bilhah and Zilpah, his father's wives. And Joseph brought a bad report of them to their father. Now Israel loved Joseph more than any other of his sons, because he was the son of his old age. And he made him a robe of many colors. But when his brothers saw that their father loved him more than all his brothers, they hated him and could not speak peacefully to him. Now Joseph had a dream, and when he told it to his brothers, they hated him even more. He said to them,
"Hear this dream that I have dreamed. Behold, we were binding sheaves in the field, and behold, my sheaf arose and stood upright. And behold, your sheaves gathered around it and bowed down to my sheaf."
His brothers said to him,
"Are you indeed to reign over us? Are you indeed to rule over us?"
So they hated him even more for his dreams and for his words. And then he dreamed another dream and told it to his brothers and said,
"Behold, I have dreamed another dream. Behold, the sun, the moon, and 11 stars were bowing down to me."
But when he told it to his father and to his brothers, his father rebuked him and said to him,
"What is this dream that you dreamed of? Shall I and your mother and your brothers indeed come to bow ourselves to the ground before you?"
And his brothers were jealous of him, but his father kept the saying in mind.
All right, now let's take a pause. Mm-hmm. And we're going to sing a song.
Yes, what is this song called?
It's going to be a nice song. It's
yes, called we know that.
Dream by Imagine Dragons, except I changed the word.
Yes, to fit the story we just read.
Exactly, yes. I did just that. And I don't claim to be a singer or anything, so just relax and enjoy my shaky voice.
Yes, I think we can already know that.
You didn't have to roast me like that.
And please enjoy this song. Thank you, goodbye.
Goodbye.
With the flocks, pasturing the flocks, with my other brothers, they hate me because of father. And I'm young, only 17. They gave a bad report to our dad, now their hatred's further. I'm not just a product of old age, so much more than all the colors that is on my room. Behold, you need to hear this dream. We all were binding sheaves, and then my sheep stood, and all your sheaves gathered around, and they start bowing to my sheep in the wind. That was my dream. I have these dreams. You hate my dream. In the eyes of 11 siblings, oh, the loveliest of all the offspring Israel ever had. I can speak to him peacefully. I can only speak in spite and hatred because of my resentment. Behold, I had another dream. The sun had bowed to me. The moon did the same. And there was these 11 stars I was counting. They also bowed to me. So that was my dream. I have these dreams. You hate my dreams.
I know that's delirious. What dream was I dreaming? Should you guys buy yourselves to the ground? But I thought we should hear it. All of my strange dreams I've dreamed. Your rebuke is actually understood.
Behold, I have these bizarre dreams. Your sheep bow to my sheep. I know that sounds fresh, but I just had another dream. And these dreams I have dreamed tell me that I'm to reign. These are my dreams. I had these dreams. You hate my dreams. These are my dreams. I had these dreams. You hate my dreams.
His brothers went to pasture. Their father's flock near Shechem. And Israel said to Joseph,
"Are not your brothers pasturing the flock at Shechem? Come, I will send you to them."
And he said to him,
"Here I am."
So he said to him,
"Go now, see if it is well with your brothers and with the flock, and bring me word."
So he sent him from the valley of Hebron, and he came to Shechem. And a man found him wandering in the fields. And the man asked him,
"Where are you seeking?"
He said,
"I am seeking my brothers. Tell me, please, where they are pasturing the flock."
And the man said,
"They have gone away, for I heard them say, 'Let us go to Dothan.'"
So Joseph went after his brothers and found them at Dothan. They saw him from afar, and before he came near, they conspired against him to kill him. And they said to one another,
"Here comes this dreamer. Come on, let us kill him and throw him into one of the pits. Then we will say that a fierce animal has devoured him, and we will see what will become of his dreams."
But when Reuben heard it, he rescued him out of their hands, saying,
"Let us not take his life."
And Reuben said to them,
"Shed no blood. Throw him into the pit here in the wilderness, but do not lay a hand on him."
That he might rescue him out of their hands to restore him to his father. So when Joseph came to his brothers, they stripped him of his robe, the robe of many colors that he wore, and they took him and threw him in a pit. The pit was empty. There was no water in it. Then they sat down to eat. And looking up, they saw a caravan of Ishmaelites coming from Gilead, with their camels bearing gum, balm, and myrrh, on their way to carry it down to Egypt. Then Judah said to his brothers,
"What profit is it if we kill our brother and conceal his blood? Come, let us sell him to the Ishmaelites. Now let not our hand be upon him, for he is our brother, our own flesh."
And his brothers listened to him. Then Midianite traders passed by, and they drew Joseph up and lifted him out of the pit, and sold him to the Ishmaelites for 20 shekels of silver. They took Joseph to Egypt. When Reuben returned to the pit and saw that Joseph was not in the pit, he tore his clothes and returned to his brothers and said,
"The boy is gone, and I, where shall I go?"
Then they took Joseph's robe and slaughtered a goat and dipped the robe in blood. And they sent the robe with many colors and brought it to their father and said,
"This is what we have found. Please identify whether it's your son's robe or not."
And he identified it and said,
"It is my son's robe. A fierce animal has devoured him. Joseph is without a doubt torn to pieces."
Then Jacob tore his garments and put sackcloth on his loins and mourned for his son many days. All his sons and all his daughters rose up to comfort him, but he refused to be comforted and said,
"No, I shall go down to Sheol to my son, mourning."
Thus his father wept for him. Meanwhile, the Midianites had sold him in Egypt to Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh, the captain of the guard.